Best of luck at the coming Shiremut, Bishop.
I would tell you my fate is in the hands of our Lord, but somehow I believe that won't be the whole story.
You fear something?
I fear everything these days, in small doses.
Eivor, I'm pleased you came. Welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thegn Aelfgar. It's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
If this belonged to the elderman, shouldn't it go to Hunwald next?
I suppose so. But I thought you a more fitting recipient. You'd know how to use it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and Shiremouths. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has been badgering my estate for weeks. I must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear.
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is all but ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. Today, Shire ambitious. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I...
Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. or people like you. What little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herefriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damn decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were terrified, not of being raided, but of their spouses being seduced away with all your perfumes and braiding and grooming and bathing even. How novel.
I hear you Saxons bathe once a year. Are we hunting Aelfgar, or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely. The bear's lair should be nearby. Wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right. Very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
Don't be frightened, Grim, but I believe Aelfgar has arranged for us to meet.
Oh, goodness, I've been discovered. But it's nothing untoward, I promise. I'm an honest man, and I believe that all people should live together in harmony. That's all.
Hey, Eivor, did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Aelfgar claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we? There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
This is the threshold of a beast's home. There's no doubting that. That's not a bear. Wolves.
Wolves everywhere, and not a bear in sight.
Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but... Please! My God, help me with this!
I'm in this fight with you! A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me!
This place is heavily guarded.
What's going on?
Good if there's nowhere to eat it. The houses burn, Eivor.
Yeah!
The men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Aelfgar. You can rebuild.
To be sure. But I do not look forward to the toil. Sweet Lord in heaven! The bear is returned!
The Shiremut will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well.
Aid me.
Archer, is everything ready?
The Shiremut will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yes, I'm curious to see this Shiremut for myself. I will follow. When will the vote begin, Abbess?
12 able lords of Lincolnscire have already cast their stones, but they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
It's an important vote for your people. How would you counsel my vote?
I value competent and righteous leadership, not foolish friends in high seats.
Anyone but Hunwald, you mean?
I love Hunwald as I love my own kin. But I would not put a stone in his care without fearing for the safety of both. I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
Grim, good to see you again.
A hearty hello, Drengir. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking her shores.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Aelfgar is a friend of yours, is he not?
He is, and a good man as well. But I cast my stone for the bishop.
The bishop? That's an odd strategy.
These Christians are easy to nudge about. So desperate they are to avoid a good fight, they'll agree to most anything a Dane says.
Good evening, Aelfgar.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit your support, but I do need it. The vote is closer than a cat's whisker.
It is a difficult choice, Aelfgar. Know that I won't make it lightly.
Good. Good. But let me say unreservedly that I am the man who will lead Lincolnscire into progress and victory.
I do not doubt your convictions, Lord.
A vote for Hunwald will return the House of the Ferocious Swan to its former glory.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord. Have you any advice before I vote?
Lord Hundbeor was a bold and honest man. If somewhat reckless. I see the same qualities in his son. Therefore, Hunwald is my man.
King Cheowulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today shall have his full blessing.
He's learning fast. Good man. How fare you, Lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There is more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That is good to hear. Bishop.
Eivor, I must thank you for your fearless participation in our moot.
I'm surprised to hear you vouched for me, Bishop.
I surprised myself, to be honest. But I felt it would be a good test of God's faith in my judgment. Under my guidance, this Shire is crawling back from a decade of lawlessness. God knows the love that lives in my heart for the people of Lincolnscire. I pray now that he guides your hand accordingly.
Quite a gambit, Bishop. Mad enough to work, it may be.
Well then, I thank you for what it's worth. God go with you.
Free men, free possible futures.
Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them?
It is not for myself I must cast the stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need?
You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself.
All free have strengths and weaknesses. Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. Though tinged with arrogance, Aelfgar is competent and wealthy. He'd be a good elderman, but a faithful ally? Bishop can be stuffy and wallows in Christian piety, but he is wisest of the free and has already proven himself. Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. Lead your shire with pride, ferocious one.
Decreed by this lawful shire moot that the Elderman of Lincolnscire shall be son of our dear and departed Lord Hundbjor, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnscire.
I don't know what to say. I thank you deeply, madly, humbly. What more can I say? I don't know. I miss my father. I'd sooner see him standing here than... Well, I will do my best. For each and every one of you.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Elderman. As all well know, this Shire Moot's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Ceolwulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Ceolwulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results. Our good and noble friend, Aeflgar.
A septic rot has overtaken this Shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Your Grace! What is this?
Nobles of Lincolnscire, stand fast!
For the glory of the Ancients, leave none alive!
Heal yourself, Hunwald.
Mother of God! Another battle!
Hold steady, Elderman! Grab any arm you can! Work with
me! This evil!
Is this how their god welcomes a new Elderman? What's his endgame? This one's gone. Find those who still draw breath. Polish your ass, Hunwald. The Elderman's seat is yours. As your war council, I suggest you waste no time in catching this grief tosser. He won't be far.
We should first bury our dead, no?
That choice is yours to make, Elderman.
Yes. Yes, of course. We'll bury our dead, then raise a feared.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs, and tend to the remaining wounded until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
Agnus Dei, totitariat in multis super frontis divorium, lectus dejectus sit, et multi benedicient. Dominus autum et supplementum our virtu liquidia domino.